नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल थर्मल टॉक्स। इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल, आई वुड लाइक टू इन्फॉर्म यू दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द सीरीज ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशंस ऑन इंट्रोडक्टरी कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर। देयरफॉर टुडे लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द थर्मल कॉन्टैक्ट रेजिस्टेंस। इन द एनालिसिस ऑफ हीट कंडक्शन थ्रू मल्टीलेयर सॉलिड्स, वी हैव अज्यूम्ड इट टू बी अ परफेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट एट द इंटरफेस ऑफ टू लेयर्स, and thus we have considered there is no temperature drop at the interface. This would be the case when surfaces are perfectly smooth and they produce a perfect contact at each point. In reality, however, even flat surfaces that appear smooth to the eye turn out to be rather rough when examined under a microscope with numerous peaks and valleys. When two such surfaces are pressed against each other, the peaks will form a good material contact, but the valleys will form voids filled with air. As a result, an interface will contain numerous air gaps of varying sizes that act as insulation because of the low thermal conductivity of air. An interface offers some resistance to heat transfer in two ways: solid to solid conduction at point of contact and conduction through entrapped gases in voids. It is important to note that there is no convection in interfacial gases as size of interfacial voids are very small. The fluid movement is negligible. Another factor for thermal resistance is that the thermal conductivity of gases are quite small compared to solids. Hence, there exists a temperature drop at the interface and the temperature profile is not continuous. We can quantify the rate of heat transfer through the interface, which is analogous to Newton's law of cooling. Q is equal to HC, surface area, into change in temperature at the interface. Here, the quantity HC is called thermal contact conductance, an experimentally determined value for particular surface contacts. By rearranging the terms, finally we can write the thermal contact resistance RC is equal to 1 over HC into surface area. Usually HC serves as a matter of great interest and hence HC is reported in research papers. But the concept of thermal contact resistance RC serves as better understanding of explaining the effect of interface on heat transfer. Now, let us see which all factors affect thermal contact resistance. To begin with, the whole concept of contact resistance is due to presence of rough surfaces. Hence, smoother the surface, lesser is the contact resistance. Second thing, interface pressure with which surfaces are forced together. As you can see from the table below, that contact pressure increases, HC value increases, but thermal contact resistance RC decreases. The situation becomes more complex when two surfaces are joined by bolts, screws or rivets, since the interface pressure in this case is non-uniform. Third one, when contacting surfaces undergo plastic deformation, contact area increases and results in lowering the contact resistance. And finally, if the material is soft and the pressure is applied, there won't be any gap at the contact surface. Hence, the resistance reduces. Let us see how can we minimize thermal contact resistance. The thermal contact resistance can be minimized by applying high thermal conductivity liquids called thermal grease, such as silicone oil, on interfacing surfaces before they are pressed against each other. This is commonly done when attaching electronic components to the heat sinks. And we can reduce contact resistance by inserting soft materials such as indium, lead, tin or silver between interface surfaces. For maximum effectiveness, the foils must be very thin. We can also replace air by better heat conducting gases such as helium or hydrogen to reduce thermal contact resistance. So let us understand this better by solving a problem. Here we have an electronic chip attached to aluminium frame by epoxy grease. This setup is exposed to surrounding ambient air at 20 degrees Celsius and having convective heat transfer coefficient H 100 watt per meter square Kelvin. The 5 mm thick aluminium sheet has a thermal conductivity of 205 watt per meter Kelvin and very thin layer of epoxy grease. 0.02 mm is attached between electronic chip and the aluminium sheet. The electronic chip is dissipating 4200 watt of energy, which keeps its surface temperature same throughout. The thermal contact conductance value for silicon aluminium with 0.02 mm epoxy is in the range between 2000 to 9000 watt per meter square Kelvin. I have chosen 5000 as the value for my calculation. So let us evaluate what is the surface temperature of the silicon chip and sketch the temperature distribution. So these are the given data. So we shall begin with convective heat transfer from the surface of the chip, that is Q is equal to HA TC minus T infinity, where TC is chip surface temperature. Since the dimensions of chip are not given, I assume surface area to be 1 meter square. So Q is 4200, H is 100, T infinity, the ambient air temperature is 20 degree. So we'll get the value of TC, the chip surface temperature, as 62 degrees Celsius. Now let us calculate the contact resistance at 0.02 mm epoxy joint. So RC is equal to 1 divided by HC into surface area. So HC, we have chosen 5000 watt per meter square Kelvin. So the value of RC is very small. Resistance is very small. 0.0002 Kelvin per watt. As we have calculated the contact resistance at epoxy joint, the next is thermal resistance in aluminium sheet. So RAL is equal to length of the sheet divided by thermal conductivity of aluminium into the intersurface area. Aluminium is a very good conductor of heat. Hence, the thermal resistance offered by aluminium, 5 mm thick aluminium sheet, is very small. So let us find out what is the temperature drop. Across silicon chip, it is zero, because the entire chip is maintained at constant temperature, so there is no temperature difference. Across epoxy grease, delta TE is equal to Q into RC, that is 0.84 Kelvin, and across aluminium sheet is 0.1041 Kelvin. So we can draw a graph of temperature versus thickness. So there is no temperature drop in the chip, and there is a temperature drop of 0.84 Kelvin for 0.02 mm very thin epoxy grease layer, and 0.104 Kelvin across 5 mm aluminium sheet. The concept of thermal resistance is very simple. I hope you have understood this very simple yet vital concept. If you have liked this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel Thermal Talks, and please do share with your friends. And finally, hit the bell icon for notification.